This is the Sultanate Palace. We are going to explore this place and find out the hidden histories behind it.
There, you can see a convict, which he's the
guilty.
He's the guilty person. And on the left side here, we can find a captain of a ship, courtiers, and religious judge. And in the middle is the traders or pahang dignitary.
Crazy, we're nothing more than friends. You're not my lover, more like a brother. I know you.
Here, we'll show you the traditional weapons which are stored. Have a look.
We were like 10. Yeah, don't mess it up, talking that shit. Only gonna push me away, that's it. When you say you love me, that made me crazy.
So now we'll show you the vintage cooking equipments and the crockeries.
Don't go look at me with that look in your eye. You really ain't going.
Now we'll show you the attires which are stored in this showcase.
Without a fight, you can be reasoned with them. Don't be impolite. I've told you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,000 times. Haven't I made it obvious?
Thinking of me just like I know you should.
And next, this is a student's bedroom, and it is the most highly restricted place. This room is only for the students of Melaka, and even the queen did not have the freedom to enter it unless allowed by the students. And the main reason for such restrictions was emphasize the students' royal studies and to ensure his safety.
I cannot give you.
What is the most interesting thing about this place for you?
This particular palace.
Yes.
Yeah. The gardens and the architecture. And I quite like how it's all on stilts, which is very unusual.
How did you know or discover this place, and what part of information did catch your interest first?
Okay, how did I know it? Friends and internet. As for interest, I would say it's the history, like the answer.
What is the changes for your local income? Like, why should the local income increase or attract more international tourists? What do you think about that?
The local income is green at the moment because of the change of government. I mean, the election was just done, so yeah.
Berapa lama nih semua
bangunan? Okay, bangunan ini kita bina pada tahun 1985. Okay, dan komponen siap dan dirasmikan pada 17 Julai 1986. Okay, bangunan ini merupakan replika istana Sultan Mansur Shah. Okay, dan museum ini atau bangunan ini bukanlah seperti bangunan asal. Ini hanya replika, bukanlah istana asal. Okay? Kalau istana asal, besarnya dua kali ganda dari yang ini dan tingginya lebih kurang 7 tingkat bangunan sekarang.
Tempatnya sama sini atau?
Okay, lokasinya bukan di sini. Kalau istana asal tu, lokasinya berada di atas Bukit Melaka ataupun Bukit Sempol.
Oh, tapi sama di Melaka?
Sama di sini juga.
Berapa kos tu?
Okay, kos untuk buat museum ni, anggaran kos masuk tu dalam 4.5 juta. Okay? Disebabkan kita menggunakan semua jenis-jenis kayu seperti yang tertulis di dalam buku sejarah Melayu. Okey, seperti contoh kayu cengal. Kayu cengal ini untuk buat tiang, alang-alang ni semua. Lepas tu kayu resak untuk dinding dan juga lantai. Kemudian kayu belian untuk bumbung. Okey, dan boleh dikatakan 90% bangunan ni diperbuat dari kayu. Okay, kalau batu dan tingkap sajalah 10% saja yang gunakan material selain daripada kayu, iaitu menggunakan cermin dan juga batu alas untuk tapak.
Macam keramik tu asli ke? Keramik.
Okey, keramik tu semua memang bukanlah dari zaman Kesultanan Melaka, tetapi yang berkesinambungan, maksudnya keramik-keramik ini memang dari dulu. Okay, cuma dia telah dibawa ke ini, dan kebanyakannya keramik-keramik ini adalah pemberian dari orang persorangan ataupun yang kita beli kepada orang-orang persorangan.
Banyak juga
sudah
datang lokal.
Okey, kebiasaannya di sini sekiranya macam bermula dari tahun 2007, okey, peningkatan pelancong tu amat mendadak. Apabila kita Melaka berserta dengan Georgetown di Pulau Pinang, kita mendapat pengiktirafan daripada UNESCO sebagai bandar warisan dunia. Dan dari situ, pelancong boleh dikatakan kalau sebelum 2007 tu, pelancong anggaran dalam satu hari dalam 100 orang. 100 eh. Tetapi selepas 2007 tu, okay, peningkatannya hampir 200%. Maksudnya anggaran dalam 300 orang yang mengunjungi dalam satu-satu masa. Tetapi pelancong kalau ikut dari segi pecahan pelancong, agak pelancong tempatan dengan luar negara hampir sama. Sebabnya pelancong luar negara kebanyakannya datang masuk tiap-tiap hari macam inilah, hari-hari bekerja. Tetapi bila weekend ataupun hari cuti dan juga bila tiap hari public holiday, kebiasaannya orang-orang tempatan juga ramai. Maksud tempatan tu bukan dari Melaka saja, tetapi dari seluruh Malaysia. Dan anggaran peratusan itu, kalau contoh macam hari-hari bekerja macam ni, 80-20. 80% luar negara, 20% tempatan.
So this is the end of our trip. Hope you guys like the history of this palace. So thank you very much. Bye.
You know that since the day I met you, yeah, you swept me off my feet. You